Hello, today I'm going to show you the major improvements in the last VoluMax 7 update. Introducing VoluMax AI, giving you the possibility to set up your pictures for 3D animation in no time. Actually, the depth map creation is literally done in one click in Photoshop by using the new neural filters. There is a complete tutorial included in the package, but let's do a fast overview together. It uses the power of neural AI tools included in recent Photoshop versions to generate depth maps in one click for VoluMax. That means you can set up and animate a picture in 3D in no time. The process has never been so easy and fun to achieve. VoluMax 7 comes with a script for Photoshop called AI AutoDepth. You will need Photoshop 2022 or 2021 to make this script work. VoluMax AI is comparable to VoluMax Smart because you can use it on many subjects like interior scenes, animals, food, landscapes, and even on very complex scenes like city views, pictures with crowd like train stations, nature pictures with trees and plants. The possibilities are huge, and the results and speed are stunning. But keep in mind that the results can sometimes be disappointing. Don't forget that we are talking about artificial intelligence here, and some pictures will be converted perfectly, but others will be blurry or flat. For portrait pictures, I will recommend using VoluMax Portrait and VoluMax Smart on pictures with blurry results. I'm not going to explain in this overview how to install the script in Photoshop. Everything is explained in the package. Once the script is installed in Photoshop, just click on the button to generate your depth map. That's how easy it is. I'm now in After Effects and I'm going to open my VoluMax AI project file. Okay, here we are in VoluMax AI. I'm going to import a picture and the depth map we curated. The picture and our depth map. I'm going to double click on the Import Photo button and drag and drop my picture in the layers. I'm going to make it fit to my composition. And we're going to keep it open for now. I'm going to select my picture, just click in the layers one time and copy. I'm going back in the main comp and I'm going to click on the second button named Import Depth Map. Here I'm going to do a paste. So I have my picture in the 0-1 photo composition and I have the same picture at the same place and the same scale in the 0-2 depth map composition. And here's the trick. I have to select the layer and replace it by my depth map. To do that, just drag and drop your picture by maintaining the Alt button on the keyboard at the same time and replace your picture. We can now close these two compositions. And now you can see we're moving a 3D with quite a nice result here. So everything is quite similar in VoluMax AI than in other tools like Smart or Portrait. I'm going to go in the Effect panel here. And we have all the same options here. I can relax if I want, or make it sharper. But in this case, we have distortions. So I'm gonna put a value I'm glad with. Okay, something like this. I can use the boost, just like the other projects. And I can add parallax FX to boost my 3D impression. Okay, this is going to be slower because parallax is taking some CPU power. Okay, let's work on another example. Let's apply AI Autodev script on this picture. I'm gonna save it. Let's go back in After Effects in a brand new project file. I'm going to import my two pictures. Okay, this is working nicely. You can see we have some distortions over here. And to correct this, I'm going to use the Protect tool. Let's double click on it. I'm going to delete this drawing and draw a protect zone just over here. This should be okay. I can close it and go back in the main comp. To activate the zone protect, just go in the effect panel and raise the value. So you can see the difference here, distorted and protected. And if I move in 3D now, it's going to be okay. Of course, everything works like the other VoluMax tools. We can add some particles. Let's say, this is nice. I'm going to animate for 3 seconds. Okay. I'm gonna do maybe a zoom in. Okay. And I'm going to add some parallax effects to increase the 3D impression. Let's do a preview. Okay, this is nice. And of course, everything else works like the normal tools. You can export, you can add some flares, you can add some color effects. In this last example, we're going to use the background option in VoluMax AI to increase the 3D effect. I extracted my subject from the background. I have my background, it was cleaned, and I have my original picture. I'm going to apply my script, my AI Autodev script, on this picture. Okay, so I have the death map, I have the background, and I have the subject. I'm going to save all this in PNG files, and going to go back in After Effects VoluMax AI project file. Okay, I'm now in After Effects and I imported my three pictures, the death map, the subject on a transparent background, and the background. So I'm going to import in photo, the first step, my subject. I'm going to set up the death map of this picture. If I move my controller, I can now see that my picture is in 3D, but we don't have the background here. To add a background, we have a third step optional here. I'm going to double click on it and import the background. This is better. I'm going to de-zoom a little bit, like this, okay. I can see some distortions on the border here. I'm going to raise the relax value. Okay, so this is nice. I have a lot of distortions in the sword over here, and we're going to do a protect. I'm gonna add some parallax here. This is always a good idea to increase the 3D impression. Let's put some particles. Okay, so this is nice. I'm gonna put back my parallax here. I think it was set at something like 6 or 7. This should be okay. I'm gonna put 1/2 quality. And let's do a 3 seconds animation. And we're going to do a preview now. I'm going to animate my particles by adding a little bit of chaos by clicking on the animation button. I'm going to go at the last frame and raise the chaos value. And here is my final result. If you like the video or want to support my work, please give me a thumbs up or subscribe to the channel to be informed about future tutorials and updates. Thanks for watching and see you soon on the channel.